finalist from the mobile category is Partha, who is the Chief Product Officer of Mindshare India. So please welcome him to the stage.
Good morning, all. I'm here actually doing two cases back to back. The first one which I'll be talking about is something which we did for Boost, which is a malted health drink beverage which is made by GlaxoSmithKline in India. It's a much-loved beverage, and this is about how we went and got hold of a very elusive kind of audience for Boost as a success. So what is Boost? It's been one of the leading brands and favorite of kids since 1983, and it's been a favorite because of two things. One is they love the taste. The second is a very consistent kind of marketing approach, driven by having celebrities who are cricket stars in India consistently over time, as well as an enduring proposition of stamina. But all of this was done largely using television advertising, which is very big in India. Now, as you know, in the last couple of years, there's been a cataclysmic kind of shift in the Indian media scenario with a huge move away from television into digital media, especially with mobile being very, very prominent. So this was leading to a drop in the engagement level of kids with the brand Boost. So there were two ways to a solution. The first was in terms of the content itself. For the very first time, Boost decided to do something other than television. It created three long format digital video content pieces. Now, these were between 90 seconds and 110 seconds long, so pretty long in for an audience who's supposed to be attention deficit in that sense. All of these leveraged the biggest superstar in India, who's the captain of the Indian cricket team, Virat Kohli. And the videos kind of showed him being a kind of Mr. Miyagi for a young kid and teaching him how to play cricket and so on and so forth. And obviously, Boost was an integral part of the entire solution. So the content was great, but the bigger issue is how do I actually target the kids? Now, obviously, there are no data sources or any kind of panels or any syndicated data which tells us about the media habits and behavior of the 8 to 12-year-old, which was the core target audience for Brand Boost. So we decided to really delve a little deep into this kid, the 8 to 12-year-old kid. And we used a combination of syndicated data panels, be it Kantar, be it Cartoon Network, a whole host of others. And one thing which came out very clearly is that mobile gaming was the second highest kind of media platform of engagement for these kids. And even within mobile gaming, there were two distinct categories. The younger kids, which were 4 to 8, played games which are more sound and visual based, like Talking Tom, for instance. While as you grew older, the 8 to 12 loved strategy and action games like, Street Tokyo Racing or Call to Sparta and things like that. So we knew the context which was relevant, but it still didn't solve the problem of accessing them. Why? Because predominantly 8 to 12-year-old kids play games on phones which they don't own. It could be either their parents' phone or it could be phones of elder siblings. And what complicates the matter further is that these parents and elder siblings also play the same games on the same phones. So one of our clear diktats, because as I said, this is the first time they were doing a digital video, they said, we are doing digital because you believe you can sharp target and you can really eliminate the wastage. So how are you going to do this for us? So this is where we crafted our solution. We partnered with a company called Pokkt, which is India's largest mobile ad gaming network. And we created a proprietary kind of classification algorithm to really sharp target the 8 to 12-year-old kid. So what did this algorithm consist of? So it was a four-stage process. The first stage was to really create the superset, which is to tag the mobile device IDs of all kids who played these kind of games, which we had identified as, let's say, 8 to 12-year-old favorite games. The next stage was to actually ratify that these are actually the kids who are playing the games. So we added a layer of analytics and smart data to basically look at repeat behavior, consumption patterns over time on reusing similar kind of games and similar kind of apps. And also, you know, time of day analysis, because, you know, a certain kind of kid would be free at a certain time of day to access a kind of game. Now, that didn't fully, while it minimized the wastage, it didn't eliminate it, because we also recognized that homemakers, parents at home tend to also be free at the same time and play the same kind of game sometimes which the kids are playing. So we actually identified overlap behavior of these device IDs with certain other applications on the same platform, which might indicate that they may not be kids, and then we eliminated that set. And as a final ratification filter, we then mapped these device IDs to other third-party data platforms like Lotame or Mobilewala, which in India is a large data provider who has this kind of device ID information. And having really whittled down the funnel to its narrowest, we then served and targeted these kids the videos sequentially. So did it have the desired effect? Firstly, as I said, the objective was to reach out to the kids. We managed to reach out to 60% of the entire universe of 8 to 12-year-old kids using this campaign, which was, as I said, the first digital video campaign done by GlaxoSmithKline. The view-through rate was particularly impressive. It was 53% against the India average of around 30 to 35%. And what's even more interesting is that of those who had the view-through rate, 60% of them actually watched the whole video, which for a 90 to 110 second video is very good. Nielsen did an independent brand lift study, and that showed a shift in consideration by about 7 percentage points between exposed and control. And finally, it led to a 2.2% increase in share versus the same month a year ago, and 1.8% versus the month prior to the campaign. So in a market like India, where things are changing exponentially and mobile is becoming the most dominant medium, it's important to leverage it smartly to build a kind of business success. And our client was pretty delighted with what we managed to do for them and drive this result. Thank you.
Thank you.